must increase, I must decrease. John 3:30.
It's time to pray. Today we're going to pray that more people would hear about Jesus and that they would believe that Jesus saves them and that they would follow Jesus. Let's pray. God, thank you for all the people in the world. God, we know that you want people to hear about Jesus and to follow Jesus. So God, would you open people's hearts to believe in you, that they would know you and love you. God, help us to know you and love you. Pray all these things in Jesus' name, amen. It's great to pray for others, isn't it? God hears our prayers. Do you remember when we learned about John the Baptist? We're gonna learn more about him today and how he told other people that Jesus should be the most important thing in our life. And we're gonna see why John tells us that we should follow Jesus.
Hey everyone, I'm Megan.
And I'm Jesse. Hey Megan, what do you think of my new gloves?
New? They look kind of dirty.
Oh, they are. I just used them to help my mom pull weeds in her garden.
Oh, that makes sense. Did you enjoy helping your mom weed?
Yeah, it was hard work. When we started, the garden had weeds everywhere, but now it looks great. It's ready for flowers, plants, and vegetables.
Awesome. They call that the satisfaction of a job well done.
Who are they?
You know, I don't know. But anyway, you reminded me of today's Bible story.
I'm really good at that.
You really are. Remember how God gave John the Baptist a job to get people ready for Jesus?
Yeah, John told people to stop sinning and turn back to God.
That's right. Well, in today's Bible story, John's job was done. Listen to the story.
Jesus and his disciples were in the countryside. People came to see them, and Jesus taught the people about God. Many people were baptized. John the Baptist was nearby. He was baptizing people too. Some of the people who followed John began to argue. John had talked about Jesus, so they went to John. "Teacher," they said, "Jesus' disciples are baptizing people, and people are starting to follow him." John answered, "I told you that I am not the Messiah. I am the messenger who goes before the Messiah to tell people that he is coming." It was good that people were being baptized and following Jesus. That's what they were supposed to do. Jesus is the Messiah God promised. John said, "Think about a wedding. When two people get married, the man who married the bride is called the groom. His friend stands with him at the wedding, and the friend is happy to be there and to hear the groom's voice." John also knew that a wedding is the groom's special day. The groom's friend should not make it about himself. This was how John felt, like a groom's friend. And Jesus was the groom. John was happy that Jesus, the Messiah, had come. John said, "Jesus must become greater, and I must become less." Why was Jesus more important than John? Well, John was from the earth, and he could only tell people about things on earth. Jesus came to earth from heaven, so he could talk about things in heaven because he had seen them. God sent Jesus to earth, and Jesus speaks God's words. Everything Jesus says is true, because God always tells the truth. God the Father loves his Son. He has given Jesus power over everything. Whoever believes in Jesus will live forever with God in heaven, but whoever does not believe in Jesus will not live forever. John the Baptist told people to get ready for Jesus. Now Jesus was here, and John's job was finished. Jesus was greater than John, and John was happy to step aside for Jesus to begin his work.
John knew that Jesus was the most important because Jesus was God, and he was the only one who could save us from our sin. So John showed people what a life looks like when we follow Jesus, and his mission was accomplished. We can tell people about Jesus too and show them how we follow Jesus by saying no to sin and yes to what God tells us to do. Let's answer some questions about our story to see what you've learned today, and we'll see you here next time.